you guys for tuning in on this Wednesday. I'm so excited to see you guys today. Let me ask you, have you ever been fishing? On today, we're going to talk about being fishes of men. That's right, fishes of men. That doesn't mean you cast a line and put your hook into people. Being fishes of men means going out to share the gospel that Jesus is alive. That's right, Jesus is alive, young people. It is our job to share the word with others and let them know that Jesus wants to save everyone. Our memory verse today comes from Matthew 4:19. And he said to them, "Follow me and I will make you fishes of men." Now to give us a better understanding of what this lesson is about today, let's watch our quick video lesson.
One day, as Jesus was preaching on the shore of the Sea of Galilee, a big crowd of people gathered. As the crowd grew, the people pressed closer and closer to Jesus.
Jesus saw two empty boats at the water's edge. The fishermen had left and were washing their nets.
Jesus stepped into one of the boats. It belonged to Simon and his brother Andrew.
Simon? Don't you mean Peter?
Well, later Jesus gives Simon a new name and calls him Peter. But that hasn't happened yet, so in this story, his name is still Simon.
Got it. So where were we? Oh yeah, Jesus asked Simon to take him out on the water away from the shore.
Right, and Simon did it. Jesus sat in the boat away from the shore and taught the crowds from there. When Jesus finished teaching, he said,
"Go out where it is deep and let down your nets to catch some fish."
"We worked hard all night and didn't catch a thing, but if you say so, I'll let down the nets again."
Simon and Andrew let down their nets, and this time, when they pulled the nets out of the sea, they were so full of fish, they began to tear. They called out to their friends who owned the other boat.
"Guys, bring your boat over here. You're not going to believe this."
James, John, and their father Zebedee brought their boat over. Soon, both boats were so full of fish, they almost sank.
The fishermen were amazed. They knew Jesus had performed a miracle right in front of them. Simon fell to his knees.
He was in awe. Simon saw how powerful Jesus was and knew he must have been sent by God.
"Oh Lord, please leave me. I don't deserve to be near you. I have disobeyed God."
"Don't be afraid. From now on, you'll be fishing for people."
Jesus meant that from that day forward, they would be telling people everywhere about Jesus and his power. And because of that, many would choose to follow Jesus.
When they got back to shore, Simon and his brother Andrew decided to follow Jesus.
Their friends, James and John, left their boat with their father so they could follow Jesus too.
Those four fishermen left everything behind so they could follow Jesus' example.
They learned about Jesus, spent time with him, and discovered how to do everything the way Jesus did.
And that's how Simon,
also known as Peter,
along with Andrew, James, and John, became Jesus' very first disciples.
Being fishers of men does not take years of training or a college degree. It takes a willing heart and a little love. God can use you YPKers right where you are. You just have to ask Jesus for the right words to speak, and God will give them to you. As fishers of men, we don't use fish bait, we use love. On today, we are going to ask God to help you become fishers of men so that you and your friends, classmates, and family members can come to Jesus through you. Can you name 12 of the fishers of men or disciples that followed Jesus? You heard some of their names in today's video lesson. Let's give it a try. Simon, Peter, Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, Judas, Thaddeus, and James. Did you guys get any of those right? You weren't ready? That's okay. We're going to try again. Here we go. Simon, Peter, Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, Judas, Thaddeus, and James. Now, knowing those 12 disciples, you are going to do that for your homework, YPKers, this week. That's right, you're going to learn the 12 disciples, the fishers of men that followed Jesus, and recite them for your parents before bedtime or before dinner. Parents, your God work this week is to be a fisher of men and share the gospel of Jesus to others. It's not just the church leader's responsibility, but it is everyone's responsibility to share God's news. Now, with that being said, that's the end of our lesson, YPKers. Let us all bow our heads and close our eyes for prayer. Dear God, help us to speak up and share Jesus with others. Help us to become fishers of men. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you guys for tuning in, YPKers, and I do appreciate you tuning in for today's lesson. I'll see you next week. Until then, bye-bye.